Hello, my name is Tim from improveyourarchery.com, and today I want to talk about the differences between a wrist sling and a finger sling. And I mainly want to focus on the differences in technique, because a lot of archers, when they recommend to use either a wrist sling or a finger sling, recommend this based on your own preference. So you use the wrist sling for a while, and if you like it, well, stick to the wrist sling. But if you don't really like it and you tried the finger sling, well, then try the finger sling and then see if you like that. But of course there is something else to this argument, because a lot of archers use the finger sling instead of the wrist sling. Well, the wrist sling is more like for beginning archers, and the finger sling is more considered like when you advance more, you switch to the finger sling. And today I want to explain why, and I also want to explain well, what are the differences between the finger sling and the wrist sling in terms of technique? Because there is one important difference. If you want to use the free fall swing technique, for example, it's very difficult to do that with the wrist sling instead of the finger sling. So let me demonstrate that by going out to the line and shooting a few arrows. Well, let me first fire a few arrows with the finger sling. I've just attached it to my fingers, and I want to fire a few arrows to show you the free fall swing technique, and then I will show you what happens if I do the free fall swing technique with my wrist sling. So let's first shoot a few arrows with the finger sling. Well, as you can see, what I basically did, I just dropped the bow and then it automatically catches on the finger sling, which is the main purpose, of course. That's the main difference between the finger and the wrist sling, is with the finger sling, you actually want the bow to drop in the sling. And with the wrist sling, it's more like a last resort. So if you have to use the wrist sling, it's because you've messed something up. So let me show you by retrieving the arrows and shooting a few with the wrist sling. Now I will fire a few shots with the wrist sling, and I will still use the free fall swing technique, which I also use with my finger sling, and we will see the difference, and then I will explain a bit more about the two options. So let's fire. As you can see, it's really hard to control when the bow basically flies out of your hand. You can see it drops all the way down and it goes everywhere. So when you're shooting on the field, like I'm doing right now, it's not really an issue. But if you want to shoot indoors and someone is behind me and in front of me, they wouldn't like me that wouldn't like that my bow goes like this, flying everywhere. So if you want to use the fingers, if you want to use a free fall swing, you really have to use the finger sling. Otherwise, with the wrist sling, your bow will be dangling everywhere, and it's just basically a last resort. So if I drop the bow, I forgot to catch it, it will not drop on the ground, but it's not to use in your technique, while the finger sling is used in your technique. I will now fire a few shots with the wrist sling, but I will not use the free fall swing technique. I will use the technique I would normally use when using a wrist sling, and then we can see the difference. And you can actually see that it's kind of similar. You also, well, not immediately catch the bow, you don't grip it really hard, but you catch it basically in mid-air. So let's do a few shots. As you can see, it looks really, really similar, but the difference is I catch it like this. Normally with the finger sling, my fingers would be like this. and I would catch it with the wire between my fingers. So the sling would be basically doing all the work. And now I'm doing like this, so I'm holding it with my other hand. As you can see, you can also fire like this, but it's a different feeling, and it's what I have been doing for like a year, and I prefer actually this over the free fall swing technique. There are a lot of people that say that the free fall swing technique is just for style points. I don't really think so, but it's not really mandatory for anything. You can, at least if you don't push the bow, your bow hand in a lot of different directions, it will not cause any decreases in your accuracy or anything. So just make sure that you don't grip the bow and catch it eventually. And if you do that with a finger sling, it doesn't matter, or if you just do it with your hand, it doesn't matter, at least if you just catch your bow. And don't grip it, like hold it like this, because then you will do all kinds of things with your bow. So let's do one more shot. A lot of people don't really like the finger sling, and that is because it can be quite uncomfortable, because when you place it on your finger, it basically acts like a noose on your finger, and it doesn't really feel that well to some people. And to be honest, I'm one of those people. I don't really like using the finger sling all that much. I think it's quite uncomfortable. Therefore, there is another type of sling, which is a hybrid sling, and I'm not going to discuss it in this video, but if you want to know more about it, I recommend to read an article I've edited in this video description. It's about the differences between a finger sling and a wrist sling, but I also discuss this in more detail, and I discuss the third option, the hybrid sling. So if you want to know more about that, feel free to click on the link below, and I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please thumbs up this video, and also leave a comment on, well, what you think. So that's all, and see you next time.